what's up, guys? Welcome to Ghost Producers. We're the Disco Fries. And today we're gonna talk to you about MIDI effects.
No shit.
It's something we use in Logic all the time to make our life easier.
Gonna start with the chord trigger, which is cool because if you don't know how to play piano or you just want to get down a basic idea of chords and run through a bunch of sounds, you could set this up in advance and you could run through them. So we set up a couple chords. You got your input note, which is a single note, and then your output is the chord.
You can see it showing you, you're playing the one note, and it plays all these back. And then you can do variations, or you can add.
And they don't have to be jazz chords, like these.
That's what this stands for, fancy hands chords.
All right, next, velocity. This is just by far the most convenient MIDI effect.
Right, because the last thing in the world that you would want to do when you're running through Nexus sounds is go like this. So you don't want to do that. You don't want
to
do it.
The velocity plugin allows you to maintain the same velocity through all the notes you're playing.
So inside your computer, there's a little man that's like hammering away at keys so you don't have to at home.
No!
So it's really nice when you're just running through sounds.
And for automation, it's also very convenient.
Yeah, because now it just pops up here, velocity plugin, fix. And now you can just automate the value of the velocity instead of doing it with the little nubs that are in, you know.
Number three, the transpose MIDI effect.
This is helpful when you're layering sounds, which we'll do a lot. There's one. And those kind of sit in the same register, so you don't want that. Maybe you want to take it up an octave. Oh, that's real low.
Too low,
man. Two octaves. Ah, so much better. And then you can play them all back as one.
Note repeat. Also, a very cool effect. We use it for the little blippy 8-bitty sounds that you hear in some of our records, for cutaways and things like that. And you could tell it how many times you want it to repeat. You could have it transpose up. As the repeats go, it's transposing up.
Yeah, we just made like a couple presets. Yeah, so you can just change the delay time.
And last but not least is the randomizer. Something we've showed you that we've used in Serum before, but it is not a function on every synth. This is awesome because you can set up the randomizer to have a narrow or wide scale of velocities that it's varying between.
So this is the sound we have right now. And a whole bunch of stuff is mapped to velocity. And as I play, it's doing different sounds. It when we put it into an arpeggiator. As soon as you turn on the randomizer, it's taking all those velocities and randomizing it. Narrow the range so it's only going within 30 values.
It's important to note, put that at the end of your MIDI effect chain, because if you put it first and then you put a velocity limiter after it, you're
dumb, because you just negated yourself.
These are our top 5 MIDI effects, unsung heroes.